Scott from Worcestershire says, question for Andy actually. In your opinion, do you think the planet X is capable of supporting life?
This is the fundamental problem that Sitchin had in terms of his astronomy knowledge. He was a fantastic, fantastic researcher in terms of understanding and describing these ancient texts, but he's not an astronomer. So his argument was that the planet Nibiru, well, Nibiru is actually a phenomenon. It's something that's described by the Babylonians as an appearance of a red star in the sky. So it could be anything really, but it pays in with the Anunnaki and the return on Anu, as Friedman was saying, who's the sort of the leader of these gods. And Sitchin put forward the idea that, okay, they're not on any of the planets we know about. They're a planet we don't know about that's got an elliptical orbit that swings round the sun every 3,600 years like a comet. Essentially a comet, but it's the size of a planet.
Or could it be the size of a sun? Could it be a brown dwarf and have its own planet around it that's capable of holding life?
Sitchin didn't actually put that forward as a possibility. This is the problem from my point of view. He said, you know, there's this planet and it goes off out into the void and then it comes back every so often. And when you see it's this red star in the sky, it is Nibiru. And this is what they were describing. The problem that I had when I was reading this, because I loved this stuff, I loved what he was saying, it just made a whole bunch of sense to me on a lot of different levels. But this was a problem because I had an understanding of astronomy, and I know, as anyone else who's got any sort of idea about planets in the solar system, is that once you get a certain distance away from the sun, everything just freezes over. You know, the atmospheres freeze out onto the surface,